Everything you need to know about fill series in Microsoft Excel. Hello everyone, welcome to Excel 10 tutorial. In this advanced Excel tutorial, I'm going to talk about everything we have in the fill series feature in Microsoft Excel. Let's get started. First, we need to understand where is this fill series option. If you click on the home tab and here in the editing menu group, you will find a drop down fill. If you click here, and here we have series. Okay, this is one way of activating fill series. Second way is a secondary keyboard shortcut, because there is no direct keyboard shortcut for fill series. The secondary keyboard shortcut means whenever you activate a keyboard shortcut using the Alt key. Okay, the secondary keyboard shortcut Alt+E+IS. Okay, now this is how you can go to the fill series option. Another secondary keyboard shortcut Alt+H+FI+S. Okay, this will also take you to the series of now that we know where we have our fill series. Now let's learn how to use series in rows. Okay, there are two ways to run a fill series, either rows and column. We use series on columns all the time, but now let's start with the rows. So here the first option I'm going to show you is linear. Okay, you'll have to always give a starting point to activate the fill series. Okay, I have given a starting point, and then I'm going to press the keyboard shortcut Alt+E+IS. Okay, and I am focusing on the series on rows. This is why this row radio button is selected, and I am focusing on linear growth. Okay, so this is selected. Now I want a linear growth in these rows, and I'm going to step up value with 1. Okay, so I want 1 2 3 4 5 6 like this, and the stop value will be 10. Okay, now if I click OK, we have a linear growth of 1 from 1 to 10. This is how you can use fill series in rows. Now let's go to the growth again. The starting value will be 1. You must give a starting value, then activate the series Alt+E+IS. We are in rows. This is why row is selected. We have checked linear. We want to check growth, and the step value, I'm going to write a value of 5, because I want a growth by 5. And if I give stop value to 50, let's say, and if I click OK, and you can see we have 1 5 25. We don't have 50. Why? Because we have multiplied 5 to this first value, which is 5. Then we multiply it with another 5. Now if we multiply 25 with another 5, it would be 125, which is greater than 50. That's why it has given us this 3 cell. Now let's check out date. I'm not sure if you remember, but here we are going to learn another shortcut to enter today's date. Control and semicolon, this will enter today's date. Okay, so this is our starting point, and Alt+E+IS for series, and our date is selected. Okay, and now here the date unit, whenever you run the series on a date, date unit will activate. Okay, so if I add step value to 1, it will increase the date by 1. And now the question is 1 week, 1 day, 1 month, 1 year, which one? So here the day option is already selected. Okay, you can add an end date here if you want. I'm going to add the end date to 5/31/2024. Okay, so if I click OK, and we have 25, 26, and we have all 5 days, and all of them has increased by 1 day. Okay, now if I press Alt+E+IS, you can also check, we could do with weekend, month, year also. And now last one is AutoFill. If I write here 1, so here we have our first value 1, and now I'm going to select a certain range and activate the series from fill and then series, and I'm going to select AutoFill. Okay, step value and stop value is not needed here. If I click OK, this is our AutoFill. It has automatically filled the same number here. Okay, now we can do everything we have done here with the columns. Let's check the linear option for columns. Start value is 1. Select the first cell that has the start value, open up series, and now here we will have to select columns. Okay, until now we were working through rows, now we want to work on columns. So we have selected column, we have linear, we have step value to 1 and we have step value to 5. If I click OK, 1 2 3 4 5. Again, for growth, let's give it 1, fill series and select growth, select column. Okay, by default you'll find rows and linear, but here whenever you work on columns you will have to select column and the type you want to use, and our step value will be 3 and our step value, let's write here 100, and if I click OK, and here you can see 1 multiplied with 3 equal to 3 multiplied with 3 again, and in this way it goes on. Here again date, remember our keyboard shortcut control semicolon, that will give us today's date. Now select the starting date, fill series, again select columns, date is okay, we are going for days, step value is 1 and the stop value or the end date where we want to stop is 5/31/2024. Okay, and here is our date. Okay, now the autofill function, write 1, then write here 3. Okay, in the row section we have selected only one value, here we are going to select two value. Okay, but I'm going to select everything, and we have given two example. Now if I click on fill and then series and autofill, everything will stop, and if I click OK, and you can see we have got our autofill. Now here in the date section we have increased by 1 day. Okay, in the day function we want to increase by 2 day. Okay, again control semicolon for today's date. Now select the starting date, click on fill, then series, our date is selected, our day is selected, I'm going to write here 2, and then I'm going to write here 6/12/2024. Okay, so I want to increase by 2 day. If I click OK and take a look at here, we missed the column section, so control Z, go again, fill, series, here it was selected as row, we have to select it as column. Okay, so again we have to do it again, 2, and stop date will be 6/12/2024, and if I click OK, you can see we have 2 days gap in between each day. Okay, now let's go for weekday. Again control semicolon for today's date, keyboard shortcut, select the cell, fill, series, select column, date, weekday, give the stop date to 6/12/2024, and if I click OK, these are the weekdays. Now if it's really correct, so select it and from the date format click on more number format, and I want the day also, so if I click OK, and here you can see as today is Saturday, it's added because this is the starting point, and after that all the time you have, there is no weekends. Okay, so this is how you get weekday. Now let's go to month, year. I don't think you should focus on this too much because it's work all the same, but still I'm going to show you. Add a starting date, fill, series, month, 12/25/2024. Okay, and of course select columns. If I click OK, we have months until the 25 December. Again for year something is similar, starting date, select the cell, fill, series, columns, year, and stop value will be same date 10 years later, 5/25/2034. Okay, now the last one and the most important one is trend. Okay, the trend is an excellent feature. Let's write a number here, this one, and now we have wrong format, this is a number, And now at the end of our range, let's write here, okay? Let's format it as number also. So we have two value and we have empty cells in between. Now, if I select everything and find out a trend for these cells, Excel can do that. If I click on fill and then series, and if I just select trend, and even before selecting the trend, you can see the step value is already given. So this is the trend. It's going to paste here. I'm going to select trend. Everything is closed. Our column is already selected because we have selected the range and the range is in column. And now if I click OK, and you can see the if the growth stays in this way, it will reach this. Okay. Now if I write here equal to this one minus this one. Okay. So this is the number increased in every cell. So we have a starting point, we have an end point, and we want to find the growth. It will deduct the value from the highest value to the lowest value and divide by each blank cell. And by doing that, it will find out the trend from us. So this is everything you will find in Fill series in Microsoft Excel. I hope you like it. This is what I wanted to show you. Thank you. Thanks for watching. See you in the next tutorial. If you can, support the channel through Patreon and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Thanks for watching.